Hello everyone and welcome to this little video. Today I will show you how you can send a cryptocurrency transaction very fast and very easy. So right now I am on the Trust Wallet and I will show you right now how to send a crypto transaction. And this applies to any coin and any wallet. It's always the same process, yeah? It's really always the same, no matter what coin you send, no matter how much money you send, and no matter what wallet you use. It's always the same process. So for now, let's imagine, I don't know, I want to send Dogecoin, yeah? But as I said, it's really for every coin it's the same. But I have a bit of Dogecoin here in this wallet, so I'm gonna show you now how to do it with Dogecoin. So I'm gonna click on Dogecoin. And I will see this interface, and it's going to be quite similar for every wallet. You'll always have the buttons send and receive, yeah? So you'll have these two options always, no matter what wallet you are using. So yeah, if you want to send Doge now to someone else, of course you have to hit send. What is this now? Recipient address. This is basically the wallet address. Who do you want to send it to? This is the only information really that you need about the recipient. This is why a lot of people like crypto, because it's quite anonymous. What is the recipient address exactly? How do I see mine? Well, if you go back and hit receive, this is what you get if you want someone to transfer money to you. And I can zoom in a bit here. This is your address. This is in fact my address. And you also get the little QR code there. I could now with my phone, with the one I'm filming right now, I could go to my Trust Wallet, hit send, and then scan the barcode. Or I can like copy in this address. This is the public address for receiving Doge on this wallet, and it's on the Dogecoin network as well. So this is really simple. I could just paste in this address on my phone, the one I'm filming on right now, and I could send Doge to this phone right here, to this wallet. So in order to send a crypto transaction, you'll literally just need the recipient address, which you of course get from the person or from the device that you want to send the cryptocurrency to. And then you literally just hit paste, but you also have this option here of scanning a barcode. You just need to accept the camera, and then you have here QR code scan, and then you can scan the barcode and it will autofill the address there. And here you hit obviously the amount of the coin that you want to transfer. Make sure this is correct. So if I want to send 500 Doge, then I put in 500, and you also see the real-time conversion here. This is obviously right now in pounds, because this is in fact my girlfriend's phone and she has everything set to pounds. And once you have filled these two things out, you just hit next, and then you'll see the fee that you'll have to pay to send the transaction. I can't do this right now because I don't have another Dogecoin address ready right now. But you will just see the fee, and depending on the coin or token that you are sending, it's going to be either a bit higher or a bit lower. Like Bitcoin and Ethereum is obviously pricey, then you'll pay like 15 euros or so for a transaction. If you send Doge, it's just going to be like $1 or $2. This, by the way, though, is not dependent on how much money you send. Yeah, so I can send $2 million and I would still only pay $2 in transaction fees. This is the really cool thing about cryptocurrencies. So this is how you send a crypto transaction. You just hit send in your wallet, you paste in the address that you get from the receiver, from who you want to send money to in the end. You select the amount, you hit next, and then you'll see the fee. You just accept basically. You can also set the fee lower. This is important to understand. So you can set the fee lower, but it's not recommended, because if you put it too low, the transaction might get stuck and might never go through. Similarly, if you want to receive a crypto payment, you just hit receive. Then there's your QR code or your address, and the other person can scan the QR code, or you can send them the address. This is a public address, so you can share this with anyone. Nobody will be able to access your wallet with this, because this is just the address for receiving cryptocurrency. Even you guys can go to your Doge wallet and send me Doge to this address. One thing that you do need to remember is you also need to check the network, like what network are you sending on. Yeah, so the classic example is always like Smart Chain or BNB. They are the same coin. You can see they have the same value, but they run on different networks. So you should always make sure that the network is correct. Like if you send Smart Chain to Smart Chain, great. If you send BNB to Smart Chain, Normally it should even go through, but like be careful with this. Yeah, you don't want to lose your money. Especially here you see with stuff like this, Dogecoin, it's the same coin, of course, but this one here is on the Smart Chain Network, I think. So you see BEP20, this is from, yeah, on the Smart Chain Network, although it's Dogecoin, it's the same Dogecoin, and this one here is on the Doge Network. So make sure that you and the receiver are on the same network, otherwise you might get in trouble. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something in today's video. If you did, smash the like button and leave a subscription to the channel. I post daily videos, mainly about crypto, sometimes about traveling as well. I'm currently on my mission to visit every country on the planet. So if you want to join me on this adventure, yeah, make sure to join my little YouTube channel community. I would really appreciate it. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.